Well, hello. Welcome back. We're here at the circular tower getting ready to construct the task assigning machine that we discussed in the last episode. I've been trying to figure out if I wanted to have it start on the floor itself or have it up higher, and I'm thinking it might be a better idea to have it up a little bit higher. That'll give us some room to work with down below without having to dig down. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be using a hopper dropper randomizer, and the way that works, you got a dropper facing upward with a hopper below it. We'll use temporary blocks for now. And you place a comparator here. Or was it... No, it was there. My bad. So you place your comparator here, and then some redstone going this way here with some... redstone torches off the side, and then you place a couple items in the dropper, and whenever you send it a redstone signal, it chooses one of the items that you have put in there to push up into the hopper. And if the item is like a sword or, you know, a shovel, something that doesn't stack, the comparator will send a 3-long signal. So if you put a torch here and a torch here, it'll activate both torches, or on the third one, yeah, third one there, so the torch would be here. One torch here, and it would activate both of them. But if you take, like, a piece of dirt, which is stacks to 64, and place it in there, and it chooses that and sends it up here, the signal will only go out once, so it will only activate one torch, not both. So you can pull signal based on which torches are activated, or how many torches are activated, or whatever. But we're going to be using a modification of this because we need a delay in there. And I really wish I'd brought some cobble or something to work with. But anyway, we'll just go ahead and set it up using dirt for now, and I'll replace it later. So we place that there, and we're going to need some redstone. And I'll put a repeater here. Set to 4. With another piece of redstone. Now, we'll place a torch there and there. And if we put like this and we'll just throw our sword in there for now. And we need a button. Where's a button? Some wood over here. Yeah. So if we put a button here, and I'll kind of stand where you can see both torches, only one went that time, one again. It's kind of like flipping a penny. You're either going to get heads or tails. You see? Both of them went, 1, 2, and that delay is important because we're going to need a delay farther on in the system in order for this to work. So, that's the first part. Now, the second part is going to involve redstone wires leading to a couple of other droppers. And... I need to figure out where exactly I'm going to need the signal to go. Go ahead and take these out. So if that's where our original signal is going to be, go ahead and place a little bit of redstone here so we got an idea. I'm going to need to branch the short one off into a separate line as well. So we're going to have two lines. And repeater. And it turns out I do not have... Oh, I have stone. I can make some more repeaters. Good. I'll go ahead and do that real quick. And, of course, getting to be nightfall. Alright, anyway, we're going to need to replace this one and this one with hoppers, one facing that way and two facing into that one. Our water stream is going to go across the top of here. And here, we're going to place a dropper. And at the end of this one, we will also be placing a dropper. Oops. That'll work. We'll just collect that one. It's getting kind of crowded in here already. All right, well, we don't need some of these lower ones. We'll just go ahead and reclaim this dirt for now. No sense using a shovel for this little bit. All right, so we need to be here now. We will extend this one space this way. Our water stream will start here. And that does not seem right there. Okay, yes, we need to drop this one. Right. We got a hopper there, and a hopper below that one. Was that right? No, that's not right. We needed to move this over one more. So we'll put the dropper there. Recover that one. And move this signal over by one. Like I said, I'm doing this from memory, so it may not be perfect. All right, that's better. we use repeaters here, here, and here. And did I have this one set on 4? May have been. Anyway, we'll have to fix the signals here to not cross, so we'll block that one off, block that one off. So now, it will activate either both hoppers, or both droppers rather, or activate just one. Now, if it activates both, short signal is this one here, long signal is this one here. Okay, yeah. So if it activates the long signal one, let's just test this out real quick. We'll put in redstone, and we'll put in dirt. And we better go ahead and... Actually, we won't put in dirt. We'll put in stone. And we'll extend this. For now. So when we hit the button, okay, it just did the redstone. And why did I get two signals? Am I still too close together? Yep, looks like it. All right, so we got to move this over one. Now we don't need to separate that. So, what's going to happen now when we hit this? Okay, there we go. Yeah, that was set to 1. Again, that one. Okay, perfect. Now, when that happens, I'm wanting these hoppers here to collect the redstone if we only want one out of here and not out of here. Well, no, it's going to collect, it's going to hit this one both times. Okay, so I got to actually run the water that way. So I did have this set up backwards. So the water will start over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Perfect. Got a water bucket on us. Should not spill out. Excellent. So, as it is right now, since those do not have power. Are they supposed to have power? Yeah, they're supposed to have power. And let's go ahead and give it a short signal. And these are supposed to be extended because that stone went all the way to the end and dropped off. A Go ahead and build our way back up again. Alright, so with a long signal. Nope, still not working properly. I may have to review my creative world and see exactly how I did this. I'd really like to not have to do that. Okay, so. Short pulse. Piece of cobble there and change this out. Maybe the repeater was here. Like that. So we need to extend the off. We need this to be off in order to collect it. Turns that off. Turns this off. Alright, yeah, I'm going to have to review that because I do not remember the specifics on how I had that arranged. I'll do that real quick and I'll be right back. Alright, well, found out what went wrong. I was drawing off the wrong signal. We want the short one to fire every time. Okay, and since these are powered, these hoppers will not pick up any items dispensed from here. They will travel on. However, if this hopper, the long signal, is chosen, it will dispense also, so we'll have two items dispensed, but we want this one, not this one. So we have to draw a signal, a delayed signal, to power this hopper. At the same time, we want the same delay to unpower these hoppers here, so that the item dispensed from here will travel along here and get sucked up. Now, since the hoppers are facing back this way, which is what we want, the item will wind up in this hopper. So right now I have the sword in here, which will give us the long pulse. So when we hit this button, you'll see they will both dispense. You saw both items go. However, the item dispensed from here is here now. The items dispensed from here wind up down here. So we'll demonstrate that one more time since there was already redstone on the ground over there. You'll see... actually, did I empty this one out? Yes, I did. Okay. So, hit this one time. Both items get dispensed. This one gets picked up by the hopper. The redstone continues on. Now, you might ask yourself, why go through all that trouble to dispense items like that? Well, I want a certain amount of randomness to the tasks that are selected. And, you know, you've got 9 here. And, you know, I could use just a regular dropper or dispenser and just hit the button and it'll pick 1 out of the 9. And then it'll draw the next one down out of, you know, like if I had a hopper here with the chest above it, it would draw the next one down and replace it in the dropper. But it would be random which one of these 9 are chosen. And that's fine, but that's a very limited number of randomness. You get a random of 9. You know, you got 9 choices. That's it. I want more choices. So by doing it this way, I can have 18 random items, random tasks. You know, each item, each task being a book contained within. Now, the idea with this hopper train here is to feed it into a droppers facing upwards so that they can feed back into here and replace them back into here. Then what I plan on doing is I plan on having a chest up here that has extra tasks in it and a hopper train running across here feeding down into both of these. And what that will do is whichever one of these gets chosen, doesn't matter which one, the next book will drop down into the system and feed in. And so therefore, you don't know where the book that you place up here will either be in this hopper, or this dropper rather here, or this dropper. It doesn't really matter, but it's completely random when it gets chosen. You could hit this 100 times, and it might choose this one 100 times, and the book that dropped in here would never be chosen. So, yeah, it's you know, an extra little bit of randomness, and someone may find a use for a system like this. I did try using just one hopper down here, but I found that books or whatever would travel and get past it or get dispensed here and then travel on from here and then not be sucked up by this hopper here. I tried two and it almost worked, but every once in a while one would get past. So by adding the third one here, I have not had it fail to pick one up yet. So yeah, that's how this works. So anyway, I'll continue constructing this and maybe see about getting some cobble to replace, or, you know, some stone brick or something like that to replace all this with. I might want to do this in glass so that we can watch items go by or whatever, but it's not all that important right now. Anyway, I'll do that off camera and I will update you with the progress. Alright, I've got this all replaced. All that dirt's gone except for a little bit down there that I used to get up here with. Although I can jump from there to there, but in any event, it's all wired up. I've got the glass in place, the water streams are in place, the return is in place. And I also went ahead and wired up a button here to activate the system. I've got a single item and a 64 item stacked in there. And what happens now is whatever item is selected flows along here, drops down here, and then arrives right here, and we just walk in and pick it up. I might replace this later with like glowstone or something. It's not important right now. And this is basically where the wall is going to be to separate the contraption off. This way it's all hidden. But the way it operates now, I've got, just for test purposes, dark oak wood in this one, and dirt in this one. Now, the one thing that I didn't realize would happen is that since this powers this constantly, it's constantly on, any item that winds up in this hopper will not drop down in here until it is activated. Then it will allow one or more items to fall in. So, we won't be able to load this hopper until it is activated. But I don't think that it will affect it that much. But we'll see this thing on operation now. So, you press the button, we're either going to get wood or we're going to get dirt. Okay, we got the dirt. And you'll be able to see that the wood that was dispensed is now here. And you'll see we have 39. So we'll take that, select again, got dirt again. and you'll see that it did not back up. Still got one in here. Still got 38 here, and now one over there, but 39. Hit it again. Okay, we got the dirt again. Dirt again. Don't know how many times we'll get it before we get the other. So far we've rolled, or we've flipped the penny and gotten heads 5 times in a row. Ah, that time you see the wood going straight across. Now we've got one wood. And if you go back up in here, there should still, if anything, be one. Nope, it's cleared now. So 39 plus the one would make 40. It is now set. Now all I have to do now is set up a loading mechanism for the books to contain our projects, and maybe design an automatic, like a hopper train. Something along, let's see, I don't have the hoppers on me. Go ahead and grab those. 10 hoppers would be way more than actually. And grab some chests too, just to get an idea of how this will operate. So we're going to need a hopper facing down. And maybe a hopper facing into that. And maybe another one into that. Yeah, that'll work. Maybe. Let's see here. That won't work. Where'd that other hopper go? Not under there. Not under there. Did it wind up in our collection over here? No? Well, that's weird. Oh, I bet it wound up in there. It wound up. No. No. Huh. Well, in any case, we'll have to do it this way. Like that. And to load it, put a chest up here. Don't need this one. So we can actually make a solid wall here, and we'll load it from the second floor. So what we'll do is we'll load our books into here, and it'll fill this hopper train up. as needed, and yeah, that'll provide quite a bit of randomness to our projects. So I'm thinking that for now I may tweak this out a little bit, may need some changes, may reorganize how it goes. I may load it from this side instead, since I already have kind of a thing set up here. I might be able to load it up over here instead. But in any case, I'll go ahead and try this configuration and see how well it works. I'll have to go out and make some books and some of the quills and stuff like that to write in them, and I'll have to write some projects, download them in, and run some tests with it and see how it works. But anyway, that should be it for today. I know this may be a short episode, but we did pretty much get one project, and this is actually a pretty important project, done in this episode. And I'd like to thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed and maybe learned something. I know this is kind of clunky, but it does work. And yeah. Anyway, this is UOAbigail saying, have a great day.